Welcome back to NCC News. I'm your sports director, Tim Durr. The Tampa Bay Lightning took a 2-1 lead last night in the Stanley Cup Finals, and as the parent club of the Syracuse Crunch, there are many ties between Syracuse and Tampa Bay. Crunch defenseman Joey Mormina joins me here to talk about some of his Crunch teammates who are playing up in Tampa Bay right now, Joey. And with an organization, you know, like the Crunch in Tampa Bay, where they have a lot of guys, you know, going up and down, a lot of times when you're going up to the NHL, you're not expected to be a main role player, but one guy like Cedric Paquette, who we saw last night scoring the game winner, start of the season in Syracuse, how important is it to have those guys, you know, have the organization set up to have those guys prepared when they get called up?
Yeah, you know, I think that's why this organization has been really successful, is guys like Paquette and Vasilevsky and, you know, Nesterov, those guys are able to play down here and then get called up and step in and contribute right away. It's pretty good for the organization.
And whenever you have, you know, those guys who are stepping up like that, and you're a guy who's been around the AHL for a little bit, how do you help those guys who are 19, 20-year-old dealing with, you know, moving different cities and moving back and forth?
Yeah, you know, it's a big adjustment coming from college or junior. You know, you're on your own. You're responsible for, you know, cooking your own meals, paying your own bills. I think as an older guy, you try and help them with that sort of stuff, get their off-ice life in order, so this way they can just kind of focus on hockey.
All right, and you know, we already talked a little bit about Cedric Paquette and Andrei Vasilevsky. You have other guys like Nikita Nesterov who are up there, who are playing down in Syracuse this year. Who has really stood out to you? Who's somebody that you saw with the Crunch when you were playing and you knew they were going to go contribute?
You know, I mean, Paquette was a guy right away. You knew he was he had all the intangibles. Really smart hockey player, really good work ethic. He's one for sure. I think a guy like you know, Kucherov was here last year, and you know, I think he led the league in points in the first 25 games. So we knew we were going to lose him right away. You know, Vladdy Nemesnikov is another guy who's, you know, really, you know, too good for this league, belongs in the NHL, but we were lucky enough to have him here for a little bit, and, you know, good luck to those guys.
Yeah, and, you know, one thing that, you know, always looking forward to whenever you see the guys pull up there, and you know, how does it make you feel whenever you're able to, you know, watch those guys that you become friends with in that tight brotherhood?
Yeah, you know, I've met a lot of guys over my career, and a lot of guys have moved on to the NHL and won Stanley Cups, and you know, had great long careers. So it's pretty awesome that I get a chance to play with those guys, and still keep in touch with a lot of them. But you know, try not to text them too much; they're probably getting bombarded these days. But you know, when summer comes around, there's some off time. I'll you know, probably reach out to them and congratulate them, however the playoffs end.
And personally, with you, you just had a surgery on your shoulder. How are you doing on that?
Yeah, you know, it's good. It was a little unexpected. I was hoping to kind of rehab my way back, but, you know, I needed surgery, and, you know, summer's a good time for that. Rehab the next couple weeks, and should be ready to go for October.
All right, well, thanks for joining us, Joey. You know, we're recap the Lightning's Game 3 victory. Look at some of the changes coming to college basketball, and Robin Dean joins us live from the Chase Corporate Challenge. That's what's coming up for you at 4:45.